Hello everyone, welcome back. Today we are going to learn about renal mechanism of acid-base balance, that is renal regulation of pH. We know there are three defense mechanism in acid-base balance or regulation of pH. The first line defense mechanism is the buffer mechanism, and the second line defense mechanism is respiratory regulation. So this renal regulation of pH is third line defense mechanism or tertiary defense mechanism or regulatory mechanism of acid-base balance. So compared to buffer mechanism and respiratory mechanism, this renal mechanism is very slow. It will take long duration. So in the kidney, the functional unit of kidney is called nephron. So imagine this is a nephron. There are arteries, anastomosis of artery and efferent arteriole and efferent arteriole. Whatever blood present in the artery, it is filtered to this tubular lumen through Bowman's capsule. So now we know that the pH of blood is around 7.35 to 7.45, or in an average it is 7.4. And the tubular fluid, the beginning when it is filtered from the plasma through the Bowman's capsule to the proximal convoluted tubule. So the pH of this ultrafiltrate is approximately 7.4. But when it goes down and down through distal convoluted tubule, loops of Henle, collecting duct, and ultimately converted to urine, then the urine pH will become approximately 6. Generally, they say that pH of urine is acidic. So it will range from around 4 to 8. The average is 6. How this happens? So this happens mainly by conserving the bases. Conservation of base mainly in the form of bicarbonate and secretion or excretion of acids. So this is the whole process taking place in our kidney. That means urine will be acidified. There are many mechanisms going to happen throughout this process. This acidification or the regulation of pH by the kidney happens with four mechanisms. The first mechanism is excretion or secretion of hydrogen ion. So this is mainly by proximal convoluted tubule and secretion of hydrogen ion to the tubular lumen by the tubular epithelial cell. And the second mechanism of renal regulation of pH is reabsorption of bicarbonate. Reabsorption of bicarbonate or recovery or reclamation of bicarbonate. The third mechanism in renal regulation of pH is excretion of titrable acids. It's mainly in the form of phosphoric acid. And the last mechanism in renal regulation of pH is excretion of ammonium. So these are the four main mechanisms by which kidney regulates the normal pH between 7.35 to 7.45. So we are going to study this mechanism one by one. So now imagine this is a renal tubular cell and this is the capillaries around the renal tubular cells or blood, and this is the actually tubular lumen. Now we are going to study the first mechanism, that is excretion of hydrogen ion. The tubular fluid is nothing but ultrafiltrate of the plasma. So tubular fluid usually contains sodium, chloride, bicarbonate, phosphate, glucose, amino acids. Through this process of formation of urine, many compounds which are required by the body are reabsorbed. So whatever not required, it will be secreted to the tubular lumen. Now in the tubular epithelial cells or renal tubular cells, as a result of tissue metabolism, so there is generation of carbon dioxide and water. So we know that after glycolysis and TCA cycle, there is generation of carbon dioxide and water. So this carbon dioxide and water, with the help of carbonic anhydrase enzyme, it will be converted to carbonic acid. So the enzyme here is carbonic anhydrase. So this carbonic acid, it is unstable, it's immediately converted to hydrogen ion and bicarbonate. This hydrogen ion will be secreted to the tubular fluid in exchange with sodium. So the hydrogen ion will be secreted into the tubular fluid. At the same time, the sodium will be going into the tubular epithelial cells from the tubular fluid. So this is called antiport. So sodium is coming into the tubular cells, whereas hydrogen will be secreted to the tubular fluid. This is called antiport, sodium hydrogen exchange here. So this is actually the first mechanism where hydrogen ion will be secreted into the tubular fluid. So you know that initial ultrafiltrate, the pH is almost same that of plasma, but now it will be acidified. So this bicarbonate and sodium together, they will be diffused into blood. So this is the first mechanism. So the first mechanism is excretion of this hydrogen ion, or excretion or secretion of hydrogen ion to the tubular fluid by tubular cells. Now we'll see the second mechanism, reabsorption of bicarbonate. So we know that in the tubular lumen we have bicarbonate here, so which is actually filtered from the plasma. And in the proximal convoluted tubule, we already have hydrogen ion. So in the first mechanism, we already learned there is secretion of hydrogen ion by the tubular cell to the tubular fluid or tubular lumen that takes place in proximal convoluted tubule. And in the ultrafiltrate, we know that there, apart from sodium, there is also bicarbonate in the tubular fluid. So now, in order to acidify urine, our kidney tries to recover this bicarbonate. This is called conservation of base. So how this happens? This bicarbonate and this hydrogen ion, they combine and they will form what is called carbonic acid. So this carbonic acid, with the help of carbonic anhydrase enzyme, it will be converted to carbon dioxide and water. Now this carbon dioxide will diffuse into renal tubular cell. So inside the renal tubular cell, with the help of water, again it will convert it back to carbonic acid. Again this carbonic acid, is which is unstable, it will be dissociate to give hydrogen ion and bicarbonate. Now this bicarbonate along with sodium will be diffused or reabsorbed into the blood. This is actually reabsorption of bicarbonate. So remember here, this recovered or reabsorption of this bicarbonate into the blood is the same bicarbonate which is filtered in the nephron or in the Bowman's capsule into the tubular lumen in the form of tubular fluid. So this bicarbonate along with hydrogen ion, they will form carbonic acid and they will be converted back to carbon dioxide and water with the help of the enzyme carbonic anhydrase. And this carbon dioxide diffuses into the tubular epithelial cell. In the tubular epithelial cell, it combines with water to form carbonic acid. And this carbonic acid again converted to bicarbonate and hydrogen ion. So this bicarbonate, which is actually formed from this bicarbonate which is filtered to the tubular fluid, and it will be recovered to the blood. So our kidney tries to recover this bicarbonate. This is called conservation of base into the blood. This is a reabsorption of bicarbonate or reclamation of bicarbonate in order to acidify the urine. So this is second mechanism. It is called reabsorption of bicarbonate. We will see the third mechanism, that is excretion of acids, especially phosphoric acid, we call titrable acids. So in the tubular fluid, we know that from the plasma, phosphate also filtered to the tubular fluid from the blood. So now this phosphate combines with hydrogen ion. So already there is hydrogen ion secreted by the tubular cell to the tubular fluid. Now this phosphate which is filtered combines with this hydrogen ion to form phosphoric acid. So this phosphate is actually base which is filtered from the plasma. Now this will become acid. So already there is acidification of tubular fluid by secretion of hydrogen ion by the tubular epithelial cell, as we studied in the first mechanism. Here further the base phosphate will be converted to acid, phosphoric acid, and it will be excreted in the urine. It can be excreted in the urine as sodium dihydrogen phosphate. So this sodium is already filtered. So this is excretion of titrable acids. So this is further acidification of urine. The last mechanism is excretion of ammonium. Here from the blood we have glutamine. It will undergo deamination to give glutamate. It will give alpha keto glutarate and it will release ammonia. And this alpha keto glutarate enters citric acid cycle and it will be converted to carbon dioxide and water. Again this same process. Now this, as a result of deamination of glutamine and glutamic acid, the ammonia which is released, it will diffuse into the tubular fluid. So this ammonia will be released into tubular fluid. Now this ammonia combines with this hydrogen ion and to give ammonium. So this ammonia is actually base, whereas this ammonium will be acidic or acid. So in the tubular fluid we have chloride. So this chloride can combine with this ammonium and excreted in the urine as ammonium chloride. So this is the last mechanism, excretion of ammonium. The end result, conservation of bicarbonate and secretion of hydrogen ion. So whatever the pH, the initial pH is around 7.4, it will be converted to around 6. So generally the pH of urine is acidic because there is an acidification of urine with all these four steps, that is excretion or secretion of hydrogen ion, reabsorption of bicarbonate or reclamation of bicarbonate, excretion of titrable acids and excretion of ammonium. This is actually the renal regulation of pH. So even though it is a slow process, it will take long duration, but it is a very very important in order to compensate acid base disorder. Renal regulation of pH. Thanks for watching.